I'm going to put gloves on and we're going to put the hair up as well, just so we can take a look at the spine. Today I'm going to do a back exam. And according to how the results look, we're going to individualize the treatment to make sure that you get a personal approach. I'm going to go ahead and split the hair into two sections. I'm going to start by ablating C1 and C2. Looking for any vertebral dislocation, any swelling. As I'm pressing down, I'm looking to see if there's any redness that comes out. The redness can mean that there is less oxygen in the area. A little bit of redness at T1. And this adjustment will definitely help to increase mobility in the spine area. There's a slight 10 degree to the right, indicating some sort of abnormal curvature. We're going to keep an eye on it, but definitely the adjustment will help so that you don't develop any scoliosis. I'm going to go ahead and palpate the scapula as well. Thank you. Let's go ahead and take some measurements. Seems to be a good proportion between the cervical and the thoracic area. I need to take a few measurements. So it's going to feel a little bit cold. Crease of angle. Measure the length between T5 and scalp here. A little bit of swelling as we get towards the end of the thoracic area. I'm going to tap on the spine. I'm going to look for any abnormal neurological impulses. So any kind of pulsations around the spine could mean that there is a deficiency in the nerve impulse. Any pain here?
No.
Go ahead and tell me if you feel this on the left or right.
Right. Left. Left. Right. Left. Right. Left. Left. Right.
You mentioned earlier that the pain is kind of on the right side,
yeah.
Localized. And does it go towards the middle as well?
A little bit.
Go ahead and tell me if this feels sharp or dull.
Sharp. Dull. 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 Sharp. 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 Dull. Dull. Sharp. Sharp. Dull. 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 Sharp. Sharp. Sharp.
Okay. And go ahead and tell me if you feel this 2 pressure points or 1.
1.
2 or 1.
1. 1.
Sensitivity on the right side, so that tells me that might be an impinged nerve that cannot be ramified to the spine. So we're going to go ahead and just try to increase circulation in this area and increase mobility in the spine, thoracic and cervical, and see how that helps you. The first thing that we're going to do is to use a skin pulling technique that really helps to get in the tissue and soften any fibrous tissue that has been formed. So it's going to feel kind of like a pulling sensation and then a fast release. Let me know if you feel any kind of pain. I'm going to start with the side that hurts the most, and then I'm going to balance it and move to the left side as well. You might definitely see some redness. That just means that the side we worked on lacked oxygenation, and the treatment is definitely going to help bring oxygen and nutrients to the area. Okay. I'm going to apply anti-inflammatory oil. This is going to feel kind of like warm in the beginning, and then it's going to cool down. So first we're going to use some cupping therapy on the shoulder and neck area. I'm going to make sure that it moves so that we stimulate blood flow. See some redness. I'm now going to do the same thing on the left side. This helps to remove toxins that have been accumulating in the muscle. I'm going to focus on the middle back. We're targeting paraspinal muscles. Thank you. to blame some acupuncture to relieve tension around the spine. To apply some cold therapy. What this does is to apply gentle multiple pressure point therapy. It helps to break down the lymphatic accumulation of toxins. Now we're going to work on your lymphatic system. What this does is to allow for more natural drainage. going to go ahead and put your hair down now. We'll do a scalp treatment as well to make sure that we're stimulating blood flow. To go ahead and use some hair pulling methods. So first we're going to focus on the hairline. And do a scalp massage in addition to the hair pulling. This also helps to stimulate blood flow. Basically, focusing on the base of the skull to bring a better movement to the spine. Okay.